Hey guys, Jordan Winkler, thank you for watching. Today I'm out here with a 6-hour Model 556, chambered in 556 this time. If you guys have been following my channel, you know I recently reviewed the 6-hour 556 XI Russian, the 7.62 caliber version of this rifle that takes AK magazines. Today I'm just basically out to see how this rifle functions, to make sure that it is reliable with a variety of different AR-15 magazines. I have the Primary Arms Micro Dot MD-RBG Roman numeral 2, and I've thrown this on here on a cheap UTG mount, but again I just kind of want to see that this rifle is reliable today and functions with a variety of ammo, mostly Wolf, and different AR-15 magazines. So let's get started. This model of 5.56 does have last round hold open, so just like on an AR-15, once the last round of the magazine is shot, the bolt will hold back, and then you can use this button to chamber the round of a fresh magazine. We here at Tactical Response recommend that every time you put a fresh magazine in, you run the action. But just in case you guys are interested in that, it does have that option on it. Now, this is different from the 6-hour 5.56 XI Russian that takes AK magazines, and you AK owners will already know what's up with this. Every time you put a magazine in, if the gun's empty, you don't have the option of this button, you must run the action. Just like with the Russian model, most of the controls on the 5.56 are ambidextrous. This charging handle, for example, is reversible, left or right side, but when the stock's folded, you definitely would want to have this charging handle on this side. Because if it's on this side, the stock or the stock with the cheek riser could impede function of it, as you guys can probably see there. But when it's reversed to that side, you could shoot it with the stock folded if you had to. The safety selector is ambidextrous. You can see the throw is pretty short. The grip is very ergonomic. The magazine release, you can bring it up here. And since we always bring a fresh magazine up when we reload, you can bring the fresh magazine up, hit this with your thumb, the magazine pops right out. Okay? Or if you prefer, if you're used to the AR-15, non-ambidextrous AR-15 guns, you can hit it here with your index finger and it pops right out. It does have a full-length Picatinny rails. You guys can put whatever optics or sights or whatever you want on there. These backup iron sights that it comes with actually work very well. Flip up and down, feel very rock solid and secure. And it has this rail that you can put sections of rail for whatever you'd like to mount on this gun. Right now I have a foregrip and a little piece of rail to mount this Surefire flashlight. You can see right there, I have a piece of rail that I haven't put anything on yet. And you can move that up and down this rail wherever you'd like. We feel like the most important thing that you would want to add, if you're just gonna add one thing, would be a flashlight so you can identify your target. But again, you can add whatever else you'd like as well. All right, here you guys can see a 5-shot group. We got some Allen dots set up here, and I'm gonna go back to only about 5 or 7 yards, and I'm gonna shoot a 20 round AR-15 magazine, 20 rounds into one of these dots, and just kind of see what an average group looks like standing, shooting about a round every second. Let's go see how I did here. And as you guys can see, all of the rounds were within that dot number six here where I was aiming. So definitely combat accurate, and obviously a lot more than even combat accurate. This gun seems like it is plenty accurate. That's a lot of accurates. Just like on an AR-15, when you have 30 rounds in a magazine, you insert the magazine on a closed bolt, tap it, tug it. Magazine does not want to seat. Okay? Now, there's two ways that you can remedy this. Either put 28 rounds in your magazine, or you can lock the action open, then insert your magazine, tap it, tug it, run it, and it will chamber. So, probably a good reason to always only load 28 rounds into your magazine, whether you're running an AR or the SIG 5.56. But just so you guys know, with a fully loaded 30 round magazine, this magazine is difficult to seat. I tried it a couple times, I couldn't do it. And again, just load your magazines to 28 rounds. That was kind of weird. I don't know if you guys caught that, but the stock actually came unfolded, and I assume it just got bumped probably by some part of my sling here, and the stock started to fold itself in. One of the things I like most about the 5.56 is that with the folded buttstock, it easily fits into a Wilson tennis racket bag, much like a side folder or under folder AK will. So you don't have to spend a lot of money on a rifle bag. You can just pick up one of these. It's covert, it's simple, it's comfortable, and nobody knows that you have a full-length rifle. The 6-Hour 5.56 XI chambered in 5.56 has been 100% reliable for me today in the first several hundred rounds that I've shot out here on the range. And I've shot it with a variety of different magazines, mostly Wolf ammo, but also some brass ammo thrown in there. Right now I've got these Palmetto State Armory magazines in there. They ran great. A variety of plastic magazines, including Magpul and some off-brand ones that I just had lying around. Tapco magazines work great. These USGI 30 rounders and 20 rounders, both all function flawlessly so far, the 6-Hour 5.56 XI. Guys, this is the rifle I have been waiting for. It's reliable, it's accurate, it has very low recoil, it has very manageable weight. I wouldn't say it's terribly light, but it's certainly not heavy. And with enough ambidextrous functions on it that you can set it up any way that you'd like. So far, I would say that I would highly recommend the 5.56 XI chambered in 5.56 from 6-Hour.